I've never made meatballs before. The only reason I'm making them is because I had sliced beef already in the freezer. So I got John to get me some sausage meat and butchers. So that in there. So we're gonna see how this goes. I've got a pot with water in it. It's got some diced totties, diced turnip and carrot. So it's only got one baked totty in it, the unit was in the fridge earlier, and it's got a packet of diced veg. No, that other one there to make shepherd's pie. So I'm gonna unravel this beef. It's thinly sliced up. This beef's been in the freezer, so I've already for the gravy. I've already diced onions, a sliced onion, sliced mushroom. I think I'll put the leftover courgette in there as well. Because in this wee bowl, I've got finely diced onion, mushroom, and courgette. And that goes in with the sausage meat. My favourite at the moment. Right, we're gonna take, I've put that down there now, but we're gonna take a bowl, this sausage meat, we're gonna put the bag up the side. I don't know how many I'll be making. Half it, I'd say. Nah. Put it all in there. Make too much. Washer hose definitely means you've cooked after you've touching that, because it's no cooked meat. Right, we're going to put herbs and spices. Oh, don't think I've opened this one yet. So we're going to put some garlic granules in here. I'm going to put seedy crap. Black pepper in it. I'm going to put some white pepper in it. I might make it a wee bit spicy, almost spicy, but peppery. That's enough. Some mixed herbs. Some salt. I was glad to some Worcester sauce in there. We can get away with that. No, put that in it. No, we can, but I can't. Right. Oh, there's fork. Just fork that through the sausage meat. Then we're going to put veg in it. I need more horns on here, but balls are a bit too wee. My whole hand and the ball and all the film stuff, so I'll run it. Stuff that on there. Most of that chick was in that paper. Scratch that noise. Told you when I was getting some scratch every time I do a video. Right. Put all this way down here. I just had a leftover courgette that's in the fridge. So I thought, I'll just cut that up really, really wee and put that in there and see if my boy will eat it. Because it's, I'm hoping that he'll like these. Because it's sausage that he likes. So, and I've got my oven on at 200, like my normal. Put everything on at 200. I've got a frying pan out because I'm going to burn these off first. It's Big John loves these, so. Better put the kettle on. Fill the kettle up and put it on because you need that for your stock. So that's the kettle on, so it'll be a wee bit loud with the kettle gone. Get that bowl out of here. Get this jug. Put this beef cube in there. Right. Where did it go? I don't have string to hold it all together, so I've got cocktail sticks, so just need to watch what you're doing when you're taking them out. You need to make sure that you know how many you're fitting them and how many to come out, because you don't want to serve somebody with a cocktail stick in it. So let's change this fork to a spoon. Are they a wee spoon or are they a big spoon? Why no? Gonna do it. I don't know how this is gonna go. Put that one there. Doesn't matter. Put too much in here, but I have watched folk make beef olives on YouTube, but I thought I'd wing it. Roll it up. Hey! We'll tuck that in. There we go. A little salt and pepper, that, but oh well. Don't need all that much. All that salt and everything else, and pepper and everything else. So, Yes, I know I'm touching other things and moments, but it's all getting washed after it. It's not like I'm going to touch it and that when I get washed. So put that in there. I've got a cocktail stick, but we'll try it. We'll see. I think I will put a cocktail stick in it the before I fry them. But just now they're frying without. So, these are cut kind of like the fatter side and the thinner side. So all I'm doing is putting on the fat side and then rolling it up towards the thinner. If it's too much, just take some of it off them and that'll be fine. So the kettle's just boiled, but I'm not going to touch it because I've got meat oil on my horns, so I'll sort that out in a minute. I'm doing this flatten out a wee bit. Make that a wee bit thinner. Around the sausage meat and then just roll up. Hopefully this will be alright. Cause I don't even know how many slices of meat we've set in this, but take that bit of fat off of there. I'm sure it would have been fine to stay on if I was cooking this for hours, but I'm cooking it for 1.5 hours. Not got the time to put it. I used to have a slow cooker, but it went to put on me, so I had to put it in the bin. That was a sad day. Very sad day, and I've just not got room to actually get myself a new one. So I'll get that at some point. I've not got a slow cooker, so I'm just gonna use the oven and cook it in there. Itchy neck. That's better, I can get the rest of that all mixed in. That's what smells good. I was actually thinking to myself, could I actually add paprika and spices to the fillin and then have like a creamy kind of sauce with the beef? Well, not like beef balls, but this proper beef balls, no. Different version, if you know what I mean. So, well, I've only got enough two beef things left. The rest of the sausage meat can get put into wee bowls and fried off in the frying pan and then just put in the pot as well. One more. Excuse me. 8. Well, let's see what we can do with this. They might break up because in the frying pan, don't have really any binder, like. An egg or anything in it, so I don't know if it'll stay in that shape. So, let's see. And talk to myself again, sorry. I was going to divide this one into two, just make it into one big one. And then that's that, and that's 4. And then we're going to put that in the sink and wash my hands. Toothpicks. I'll tell you what I'm cooking up. Toothpicks and all. This dish was over here. It was the dish that they thrust that me in. Oil in it, properly oil in it, olive oil, it's got garlic in it, I know, but I've not got any, and it's not got any flavour in it. Just use that. I'm looking for these, and it's going to go in the oven in a big dish. A big round dish like this, and it's got a lid. They're doing the it's got a dish, a lid to go on it, so. Wait for this frying pan to heat up. The reason I've got courgette in this one is because it's half of what was in the filling, so I'm still wasting it. I'm going to use it in gravy. Oh, there we go. I've been forgetting that the kettle had boiled, so we're going to put it in. A few pint of water. And I will be using gravy granules in it. Get that to dissolve. That back trim one that's got the stuff for making mash. Please. And yeah. only reason I had to fix it is because I seen online that folk is struggling to keep them unraveling. But I don't have string, so. But I don't think I'll need the toothpicks. That's 5 in a pan. Let them cook pretty well. So the video that I made meatballs in it, and John wants me to make them again because he says they were good, so we'll make mayo again. But I'll not record that because I don't want to watch me doing the same thing over and over again. You might find that some of the things that I'm doing it's like the same kind of stuff, but it's done in a different way. Like we've got my beef strips, a couple of videos ago I done like the sliced beef in gravy, and that's basically what this is, but it's just wrapped in sausage meat. And as I'm on, I'm going to put this dish on a baking tray. It's stuff there for me to lift it and to the kind of grab a fluffy little dish at the oven. Just a little. And then that. Again, telling you just to watch it, so that it not to spit at the end or the spit in the meat.
Don't let it come through and spit on you.
Very funny. What do you think so far?
Well, it's really nice, River. You've done a marvellous job. That's no way it came through from kind of cold.
I'm on the fridge. It's moving in the fridge.
Yeah.
Oh?
That's alright.
I'll let you wait to try and get room in the fridge for it.
You're acting like that's such a problem, the room's not enough room in the fridge.
I can get you cheesecake if you want to eat cheesecake. I can give you a little bit of a little cheesecake when I'm trying to make dinner for them. Same order, so take the greaseproof paper off your chopping board, unless you've got a chopping board that's specifically for cutting meat or doing meat on it. I don't, so I'll use greaseproof paper. Sorry. With the gravy and all. Right. Right, we're gonna redrop more of this all in there, and we're gonna put all this veg in here. Do those cut courgette, mushroom, and at the very bottom those last sliced onion. All right, now. we put the salt under it. So, crack black pepper instead of white pepper. And a bit of last one. Right. There we go. Turn the heat up in the frying pan. We're gonna stock. On it. If I'd had the pesto powdered stuff, I'd use that, and it's just like corn starch. Spoon feed that pesto stuff with some just a wee touch of water in it, then mix it in with the stock. It just comes thick. I don't want to spill it. We'll get it after them. Hopefully I can get... I'll get up to John when he goes to tea. I just... John does work more, it's just his back shift, so I'm gonna get up early. Hopefully this is cooked enough. Cook it to walk it. Please don't say it's got a thick layer, it got me this. Right. We're going to put this. You can't even see me, it doesn't matter. You know what I'm doing? I'm going to put the fried veg in the fry pan onto that bit of the beef olives. Spread them out throughout the pan, the dish. I'll bring it over here so that you can see what I'm doing. See the beans on this corner. Just need a bigger kitchen. Wish I had a bigger kitchen, but I get what life brings us. There we go. Right, so the veg are in, beef olives in. Let's get pouring this gravy over it. Oh, it's got to run all the way down. There we go. Water just to get the thick stuff at the bottom. Because I wasn't still in my water. Not much. There we go. Right. That's all that in there. And we'll put the lid on. Put it on. I might ask John to lift that out for me. It's a bit heavy. There we go. All that's done. and I'll show you it when it's out the oven. Oh, out of breath. And I've got my mash top, my mash bed cooking away. Yeah. So I'll see you when I'm back. Right. I've done mash, but it looked horrible. Don't know what happened to it, it's went auburn. It looks orange on there, but it was turnip and carrots that were in it. So I'm going to take the lid off this and then we're going to dip it up. Two ones, Gemma. Oh, it smells really good. That right there. I'm just putting the stuff so that that goes back in right there. And then open that in and the fridge. And if I go outside the fridge office now, I'm only going to do the wee man one because I don't know if he's going to like it. I have to take all the stuff off the top of it. And he will not eat the. Right, me man.
Yes.
Right. This is a beef olive.
Okay.
Okay. You don't like it. Make something else for yourself. This is what me and your dad are having. So you know, and you don't want to eat mashed potatoes. So maybe not. Try that and see how it goes.
Okay.
One of John's well leaps. Right. One. Two. And if there's any extras, then John likes it. It is what more. I'd take John to mash this because I've never had the strength to do it. Smash them up with carrots. Quite a lot of veg, aren't there? John! We'll be in the mirror if you like it for your work tomorrow.
Cool, okay? Thank you. You know you're done. See when you've deleted all the saved data after fucking Xbox.
Oh, there we go. So that's what I made tonight for dinner. Hopefully everybody likes it. First time trying to make it. If John likes it, he'll get it made for him again. So, see ya.